Yo, if you're a private security professional wanting to take your game to the next level, go to executiveprotectiontrainingday.com to check out my personal success package for private security professionals. Essentially, it's everything I know about executive protection and a lot of soft skill training on the techniques, tactics, principles that I believe make it so some protection agents succeed while others fail, regardless of background. Anyways, check it out, executiveprotectiontrainingday.com. And remember, y'all, hard skills do save lives, but soft skills get you paid. Boom. Boom. Hey, what's going on, y'all? Byron Rodgers here. And it's been a good first year for EPL, the Executive Protection Lifestyle brand. I just wanted to come to you just with raw and uncut, you know, as they say, and just talk about the brand, talk about where we're going, talk about just EP stuff, and just thank you guys for sticking with me through my first year, you know, of doing this podcast and doing this brand. It's been, let's see, we started on October 31st of 2019, and you know, I thought that was cool because my birthday is Halloween. It's October 31st. So I was like, bump it. Let's just kick it. Boom. Go for it. And see how things go. A full year later, you know, we're still averaging, you know, 5,000 listens per week. So you guys are really helping get the word out there, you know, and it means that there's a quality thing, a quality product. I've had the pleasure of, like, on a few details, just being like able to just say, hey, bro, you should check out this episode. We're talking about some things that, you know, I think could really help you take your game to the next level. And boom, you know, folks, I've gotten really positive feedback. I heard that one of the podcast episodes is being given as homework in an executive protection training, actually at a college, during a college course. So, you know, the content is high enough quality that it can contribute to college credits. You know, that, you know, for me, it's an honor, you know, and it's obviously, it's not me sitting here talking. It's the quality of the people that believe in the podcast and that believe in the industry and that are willing to come and get on the podcast. And then it's really you guys getting the word out. You know, it's you guys saying, hey, this is a good tool. There's some good info. Check out these episodes and getting the word out to your friends and your coworkers and other professionals about the Executive Protection Lifestyle brand. So I just want to thank you guys. You know, it's a beautiful thing, and it's turned into such a beautiful thing, you know, because now we've got the Protector Symposium we're working on, getting stuff out to every year. That's huge, man. And we're going to have our own event that's essentially kind of spawned itself from this brand, you know, and that's beautiful, you know. So all you guys who are part of the brand, come out and make sure you guys are coming out and, hanging with us. And when we have those protector symposiums, I can tell you this next symposium is going to beat the brakes off the first one, man. And I'm excited. I am so excited. We had about 250 folks this last time. Let's double it. Let's have about 500. And those of you who were there, you know this was true. It felt like a family. It felt like we were just like kicking it with, where it was kindred spirits. And that's because it was. That's because it was protectors. You know what I'm saying? Like, where else do you go to a venue where it's like, regardless of your background, regardless if you're law enforcement, regardless if you're executive protection, or if you're just a civilian, a concerned, responsible civilian, do you get to kick it with protectors? You know what I mean? So I thought that was great, man. That was beautiful. That was on point to be able to go and just be in a place. And like I just told everyone at the beginning of the whole entire thing, you know, you're validated for being in this room. You know, forget about your background. You're people who take protection so seriously. You take it seriously enough to spend money and to spend God's currency and to come and join the assemblance of the brethren, you know, to join protectors in assembling. And I think that that's a beautiful thing. It's an amazing thing. So, you know, for those of you who are in the room and are listening now, like I said, you're validated just for making a decision to go and do that and then join us. And really, I mean, some of you have heard me say this, but I don't know if all of you have. I view protection as a sacred art, a sacred ancient art that's been around since the beginning of time, since the beginning of humanity, really, for the most part. You know, there's always been, we've either been protecting ourselves or protecting others, or it's one of the basic needs. You need food, water, shelter. Technically, you need sleep. You know, even though the Marine Corps taught us you only need 4 hours of sleep, you know what I'm saying? Technically, you need some sleep here and there. But you also need protection. You need to protect yourself. You need to know how to protect yourself. You need to know how to protect your loved ones. You know, how can you even really call yourself good if you can't protect those people who are dependent on you? Especially if it's your role, you know? Especially if it's your role and it's something you've signed up to do or something you're being paid to do, you know. That's something that I always pose, you know. So to me, it's one of the greatest acts of service you can render another human being. And I think it's beautiful. And I think it's such a high act of service because you need to possess a certain level of skills, a certain level of ability, mentally, emotionally, psychologically, internally, physically, in order to really render a high level of protection to someone in many cases. So that's why I think it's not something you can just go do. It's something that you really, I mean, you can, but you know, it's something that you really need to kind of cultivate abilities and skill sets and mindset and, you know, perception and all these different things to render this high service of actually protecting a human being and doing it efficiently and appropriately, you know, and not messing it up and not going too far and not causing some kind of incident or damaging a brand, you know, a client's brand while defending a principle, things like this, you know. So, you know, for me, it's one of the ultimate forms of love. No greater love than this, that a man would lay down his life for another. Well, this is what we're signing up to do, whether it's familial, having to do with the family, or even for money, it's still being willing to, you know, take life or being willing to give your life in service for the sake of protecting someone else, I think is a very high form of love. So, yeah, that is really kind of what protection means to me, and that's what I want it to mean to more people. With this brand, I really want to invest in the protection professional, you know, with the executive protection, not even just really executive protection, but really the protection professional. And I want to contribute to the industry in a way that causes the executive protection professional to be seen as a serious professional, a respectable professional, the same way, well, you know, I would say the same way we see law enforcement officers, but that's almost disputable now, the way that the public treats them, which is one of the greatest tragedies of our society, in my opinion, in today's age. But I'd like to see us respected the way that the world respects accountants, doctors, and lawyers and people who specialize in things they personally themselves wouldn't do or couldn't do. Because a lot of what we do are things that they wouldn't do or could not do. As service providers, it's not something they can just walk in and do, as we see people try to do that all the time. So, in an effort to do that, to create a higher, to positively impact the image of a private security professional, I aim to create higher quality security professionals. And that journey consists of creating products, doing podcast episodes, and generating large sums of media that help people understand the ideologies, the principles and tactics that go into what we do. And for me, it's turned out to be some of the most rewarding work, some of the best work of my life. Work that I feel honored to do every time I do it. So, you know, that's really what this is. That's what EPL is. That's what Executive Protection Lifestyle is to show the world that us as private security professionals, we're not just going to work. You can't just, this isn't like working at a restaurant, you know. If you're going to be good at doing what we do, you're investing in yourself, in your heart, in your mind every day. You're listening to audiobooks. You're working out. You're staying fit. You're covering your diet. You're working on your diet so you can stay healthy and fit. You're training firearms and lethal threat options. You're training less lethal threat options and hand-to-hand tactics and hand-to-hand combat. The hand-to-hand component. You're training soft skills so you are efficient at everything from admin and logistical management and concierge and manners, and you can conduct yourself in ways that are in keeping with the highest level of respect and professionalism. You can walk into any environment. You can make sure that your principals and clients' brands look good and look respectful and look respectable because you maintain an immaculate appearance. You know how to present yourself. You speak words good. You know, you can enunciate you're speaking proper English. Things along these lines. You're a high quality human being because being a protection professional requires that you do conduct yourself as a high quality human being. And the content I put out, I'm trying to influence individuals to that standard constantly. Because the more of us that do that, that choose to do this and choose to be these types of professionals, the more of us, the more that the public will react, I believe. And the clientele will react as well, I believe. You know, I've been in some positions and I've seen both sides of that same coin, you know, where the clients, you know, their older service provider maybe didn't have that. You know, and then they come run into a service provider who does have those levels of flexibility and professionalism and systems. And they're pleasantly surprised, you know. And in an effort to really create these higher quality private security professionals, it's, you know, we now have not only the podcast, you know, we also have the Executive Protection Training Day package. You know, I kept getting hit up, like, to the point where I really couldn't keep up with all the messages, you know, of people being like, hey, man, looking to get into the game. How do I do it? I'm sending them to my podcast episode where I literally talk about that. But then I'm kind of like, well, you know, like, you guys really want a succinct, like, big time answer. And it really evolved into this other thing where I started mentoring some cats and, you know, really kind of investing my own time and energy into some guys. And they've all gotten in and they've all gone on to do some big, pretty amazing things. When I showed up to the IPSB conference, it was amazing to see that, like, EPL is like an organism. It's like a organization. It's like a group. Like, you know, people are in there and, like, I'm meeting people from the group, you know, and shaking hands, you know. So if you guys haven't gone to any of these, the Close Protection Conference or the Symposium, get to these events, man. They're good for your, I got one of the guys I'm mentoring right now. He's getting a new job. He totally leveled up at the conference, you know, so make sure you're going to these events within our industry, because all they do is they give you more exposure. But we'll get back to that. But yeah, man. So they give you more exposure. They widen your sphere of influences. And as I've said before, you know, you're a working professional. And you're thinking, like, why do I care? Why do I need to get to an event? Like, really, you know? Well, because at the end of the day, your network ends up being your net worth. And you might have a job today and you might be killing the game today, But in a little bit, your client might, for whatever reason, downsize. The accountant might do it. Any number of things can happen. Say the wrong thing in the car tomorrow, you know, and you're gone. Just like that. Just like that. We all know it's possible. Christian West said this is one of the most unfair industries he's ever seen. So, and that's true. That's been my experience as well. You can just be gone. You wore the wrong color on the wrong day. Either way, then you find out the truth about how your network is your net worth. Really, what I really want to help you guys do is I want to help you all build your own brands. I want to help you all build brands that can help you be fruitful and that can give you options and that can put you in a position where you don't have to struggle. You don't have to try to find work. You know, you don't have to let a client jerk you around and treat you like crap because you don't know where you're going to get work or where you're going to find another client, i.e. the way I spent the first 7 years of my career, you know. I want you guys to be smart executive protection agents, but I also want you to learn how to be smart business people, smart branded, well, smart private security professionals. You know, in today's age, private security doesn't just have to do with just simply doing the work well. If you're going to be a real good private security professional, you need to be well-rounded enough to know how to do the work well, to have the soft skills to procure a good relationship with yourself, with your client, with your, well, yeah, with yourself, with your client, with your detail leader, and with your company owner. Those relationships are key. And then beyond that, with the Royal Court, which is all the relationships around your company owner, your client. And that's something we get into the ology of, the social dynamics of, in the Executive Protection Training Day package. The Executive Protection Training Day Success Package is something I put together towards the latter part of this year. In the last few months, I've been working on it all year long, making videos, making modules. It's all digital. You can watch it and go through it at your own pace. And you can get back there in that classroom and learn literally everything I know about executive protection. And for me, the reason I did it was because people kept asking me how to get into the game, what to do, and you know, what schools to go to. And I just finally was like, look, man, like, I need to create some kind of product on this, because what happens when I get on an EP detail? If you ever work with me, and if you have worked with me, you know it's the truth. I just start... basically, like, I get a new guy on a detail, he gets in the chase vehicle, and I'm like, hey, bro, this is how you survive. And I start giving him taking him through that quick training day crash course. And I'm like, these are the social dynamics around this. This is how you need to approach this. This is how you approach that. This is how the client likes this. This is how you set the vehicles up. This is, you know, and I go through these principles, and it's all very soft skill heavy, because you got to realize, like, when I came in the game, I was 21, and my client was looking for another dude to roll with us. In Cali and then around the world. And we were literally, we hit over 60 countries in the first two years, man. And we did that on repeat for 7 years. It was like learning how to drink out of a fire hose. It was evolve, adapt, or die, you know, detail. Anyways, so either way, I had a lot of experience really young. And I kept seeing all these guys that were like way more qualified than me. I was like, I'm getting fired, and he's going to keep this dude and the other dude, you know. And I was just like, you know, and I literally saw probably like, I don't want to exaggerate, but I probably realistically saw like, we'll just say 20 guys in the first like 6 months or so trying to audition for this job. And they were bigger than me, stronger than me, more well qualified than me, I thought. Better backgrounds than me, way more experienced, you know, federal backgrounds, SF backgrounds, and for some whatever reason, more EP backgrounds, you know, for whatever reason, I was able to hold on to that client for a while, and it could have been the perfect storm. But then once I got out and got into the game and got farther into the industry and started working different client demographics, I realized it wasn't. But I just started to really realize that there are principles behind why some people make it and why some people don't make it and why some people struggle in this game and why some people don't struggle in this game. And so understanding the social dynamics around the clients and doing good work and surviving was one thing, was huge for me. But then beyond that, the other piece that I ended up understanding was the branding piece and getting into the game piece. Because then, you know, I worked that client, I had that whole evolutionary cycle, and then I quit. And then I went down to Florida and had to start from scratch again and rebuilt the empire down there from scratch by the grace of God, and learned how to break into the industry again and come all the way from the, I started off in Florida the same way I started off in Cali, bouncing, and learned how to work my way up and work that game until I got into some high powered stuff and some good stuff. Then I left it again, came back to Cali, and had to break back into the Cali circuit again and figure out how to get things moving and get work moving and all that stuff, and figure out how to get back in the game again and fill your books again and work that. So, you know, I've done it a few different times on, you know, coast to coast when it comes to breaking into the industry and getting work and keeping clients for a long time. Every client I've ever had, or every principal I've ever had, I'm still in positive regard with. I can call or text them right now, you know, and there's positive feelings there. There's positive relationship there, because that's, you know, what I focus on building. But the point of all that is the training day product is really everything I know about how to do that, how to build a successful career from the digital components, the approach to the digital marketing piece of yourself, the approach to job interviews, the approach to resume building, all the way into how do you interface with your team, how you conduct yourself on the team, how do you interface with your client, conduct yourself on the with the client, conduct yourself with the client's kids, and all the house staff, the royal court, you know, you and your employer's relationship, all the way through tactics, how to set your vehicles up, how to do an advance, how to do a one-man advance on a country, which advances you send to your client, which one you send to your team, you know, how to do all that stuff, you know, how to conduct yourself in a motorcade, depending on what position you're in, every position in the motorcade, the movement, how we do movement, you know what I mean? Like, I went to some courses and it was like State Department stuff, you know, six-man movement squads and four-man, you know, formations and stuff. And I'm like, that's all great. I guess you know how to do it from the top down. But like in the private security game I've been playing, it's like two dudes, okay? You're going to be rolling with two dudes. Ain't no six man nothing. So really, how do you move with one to two dudes? And what are the considerations? Where are the gaps? What do you need to be mindful of? So, you know, it's all everything I know tactically on how to conduct executive protection operations. And also everything I know in terms of how to sell yourself and how to have the soft skills to create lasting professional relationships and building lasting professional relationships. So you have options in the private security game, and there's opportunities coming to you rather than you being scared you're going to lose what you have, or rather than you getting in the industry and not knowing where to go or what to do, or how to find work. It's how to overcome all those things, because it's what I've had to do, you know? And it's not the way, it's not the ultimate. Don't worry, I'm gonna stop talking about this product in a minute for y'all who are like sensitive to selling and stuff. But it's not about that for me. It's about me genuinely sharing something with you that I think is ultra valuable, that I know it's valuable because I've seen it work. You know, the folks I've been working with and mentoring are having progress. You know, there's a few episodes, I think I've one with Kevin, go back a few episodes in the last quarter of the year, you'll see one with Kevin McCluskey. He was one of those folks, and now he's killing it with a big corporate company out here in SoCal, you know, company car, like he's killing the game, you know. I'm proud of him, you know. But and it's such an honor and a blessing to be able to be in a position where you can invest in people. You know, I've always been very mediocre at a lot of things, so I've always tried to win through the accumulative score, you know. I'll just work hard enough. So to be able to be good enough at anything to help anyone else is like, so for me, the blessings of those things are it's priceless. There's no words really for me to try to explain how much that really truly means to me to be able to contribute, you know. So yeah, go back and check out one of the episodes, the last quarter of the year, and you'll see Kevin McCluskey there. Nonetheless, so the training day product is all about those things. It's all about the soft skills. It's all about the hidden strategies that I think help guys have options, guys and gals have options in the private security industry, and also that I think helps them have ultimately success in the industry. And that membership to those videos, and then it's all the field notes. You see me, you know, out on social media doing these field notes where I'm out in the field and I make a quick video and I'm talking about what I'm doing and how I'm doing it and blah, blah, blah. It's all those, you know. My goal for 2020 is to make sure I want there to be 100 field notes back there in that library, okay, to go along with the 13 chapters, you know. So getting those field notes back there uploaded. And right now I think there's like 20-some field notes that are being uploaded back there right now. And if you get in now, there's still a chance that you'll get the big discount for the beta test group because we haven't completed the whole product and process. So if you get in now, go to executiveprotectiontrainingday.com, executiveprotectiontrainingday.com, and watch the webinar. And if it makes sense to you, join me. But if you do that, then the cool thing is I think it's still discounted. So check that out. So that stuff's going on. That stuff's exciting. It's amazing. It's good to be able to help people. And then that product is also coupled with a paid Facebook group where I am going to be doing live Q&A once a week, and I'm responding to everyone in there because my success is their success. If they go through my product, if you guys go through my product and acquire success, and you're giving that feedback to the industry and to the game, our destinies are commingled. Our brands are commingled. So, you know, it makes sense for me to invest in making sure you guys are successful and giving that following on training, follow on exposure, following on food feedback and guidance as you build your careers, you know. So that's ultra positive. That's like one huge thing that happened this year. To have that tool to be able to influence and help people up their game is huge. And the symposium for next year is kind of the other big thing. We're thinking about doing some breakout sessions. I'll let y'all in on some of this because this is the group. This is the holy of all. This is the group, you know. So for 2020, we're looking at maybe doing something on the East Coast, maybe taking the show that we just had on the road. The show that we just had, the first symposium, is available at protectorsymposium.com. You can go there right now, purchase it, download it, watch it. It's, you know, well over 4 hours of high quality content. The speakers nailed it. I think we also did a really good job at capturing the way the atmosphere felt. Just, it felt like a big family, you know. It just felt like a bunch of people that were dedicated to protection hanging in one room. And you know, I had a mom come up to me and say, "Hey, I learned so much," and that meant a whole lot to me. And I also had an SEB, like SWAT guy, come up to me and say, "Hey, man, I really learned a lot from this event." And then I later had Christian West relate to me and say, "Hey, man, I go to a lot of these things. I hear a lot of the same people, you know, but what I really liked about your event is that I actually learned something. It was actually some new people, some new information, some new stuff, you know." So that's what he liked about the event. So then that's ultra, ultra valuable too, you know. So it was different. I think it was different than most of the things that are being done in the industry, being done in the game. What we're going to do this next year is I'm going to aim to have these kind of breakout sessions because, you know, I really want to make sure I get the most high quality content to the right people and the right demographics. And some of the content may not be pertinent to you because you might be already beyond that level. Like a medical component might not make sense for you to spend money to go see, even though it's ultra important. And our civilian demographic inside of the Protector Nation brand has never had a TCCC course, you know. So we're gonna do things a little different, but it's gonna be good. We got some awesome speakers on the roster. I ain't telling you who those are. We might add some more of a physical component, is all I'll say right now. We're gonna add a more physical component to this. You might be doing some shooting and things like that at this next Protector Symposium. with a little, I got some ideas. I ain't going to drop too much. Anyways, so this next year is going to be great. We had, let's see, what else, man? The merchandise store is finally up on the website. So if you go to EPL, executiveprotectionlifestyle.com, or you go to bravoresearchgroup.com, you'll see that the merch is up there. The merchandise is up there. Now you can get your EPL hats, your EPL shirts. I'll make some other cool EPL stuff, EPL-centric stuff, maybe a hoodie or something before the first quarter and drop that so you guys can go check that out. But overall, man, for just being a podcast, I'm so excited about this. The group, our Executive Protection Lifestyle group in LinkedIn's blowing up. And the Executive Protection Lifestyle group in Facebook is still growing. I think it's at like 11,000 now. So it's, you know, it's still just, it's climbing. It's climbing, you know. And the group, I think, is just really good because every time I pop in there, someone's finding a job, someone's introducing themselves, getting scooped up by a company, someone's throwing a request out there like, hey, you know, everybody, you know, I need bodies, you know, people are, it's meeting needs, it is a network, you know, so that whole rising tides lift all ships that are at sea thing is huge there. So, you know, the goal is to change the face. Not change the face. The goal is to change the industry positively and help us all do better. A rising tide lifts all ships at sea, as you always hear me say. But, you know, I'm all about inclusion and working together rather than competition and scarcity when it comes to this stuff. So it's ultra positive. If there are any guests you guys would like to see, over the course of 2020, by all means, please make email introductions. Email me at admin@executiveprotectionlifestyle.com and make email introductions, please. And with that introduction, give me a quick paragraph on who the person is, what they do, why you think they should be on the show, and that'll help me not have to go chase down people if you got some interesting folks that you have access to. That is big. So think about some people you'd like to have on the show and, you know, hit me up, let me know who they are, introduce us if you have access to them. And if not, then just let me know who they are and I'll see if I can get access to them, you know, and we'll see what happens. But, that's another big component. Well, who do you guys want to hear from? Who do you think deserves to be, you know, sharing their knowledge and their story with the rest of the industry for the Executive Protection Lifestyle game, you know. Going to be some more beautiful content coming down the line. I've got a lot of it already saved up. You might see a bit of a rebrand with regards to the image of the podcast and some of the stuff you'll hear as you come in and out of the episodes, but all really good stuff, all positive stuff. And overall, I just want to really encourage everyone to start thinking about how they want 2020 to look. You know, how do you want 2020 to look? I said this on Instagram today. Really about 3 or 4 questions you need to ask yourself real seriously coming into this next new year. And, you know, how do you want this next new year to look is one of them. Remember, the past is for information, not identification. One of the cool things about being a human being is that we are the sum total of our decisions and those outcomes. It weighs into the paradigm, the mindset, and the intelligence, experiential information that we have access to, and intelligence we use to make further on consequential decisions and decisions into the future. But those experiences, that information is not for identification. Those experiences aren't us. We can choose to change things anytime we want. So one of the questions is like, what'd you learn from 2019? You know, what'd you learn from 2019? And by understanding what you learned from 2019, you cannot repeat it and you can do better in 2020. The past is for information, not identification. The next question is, how do you want your 2020 to look? You know, do you want to learn more about branding and marketing yourself as a private security professional, so you're not working as many as an executive protection specialist, so you're not working as many, you know, just security stuff, or, you know, so you can really like streamline and take your professional career to the next level. Get the training day package, because that's what it's all about, taking your career to the next level. You know, how do you want 2020 to look? What are your professional goals? Figure them out. In my opinion, you should create attainable goals, because progress equals happiness. And everyone's like, shoot for the stars. I find that those people don't really get in the game. They don't get things done. They just shoot for the stars. They have a really good time dreaming it. And then they go eat a sandwich because they know they can't do it. I say aim for something you can do. So aim for some low-hanging fruit, because progress equals happiness. And you make that little bit of progress, well, what a good problem to have. Now you need to go find another target. So really, how do you want 2020 to look? You know, you want to take your EP game to the next level? You want to take your body game to the next level? What do you want to do? You know, ask yourself that question. Don't let this year go by without knowing the answer to that question. You are about to start a 365 chapter in your life, and you got all those blank pages you got to write your, and you got to paint your masterpiece on. You get to write that, you know. Don't just, you know, are you drifting through life, or are you driving through life? Are you one of those conscious people that's deliberately creating and doing something? Or are you one of those people that's just like surviving and drifting and floating around, and whatever happens, happens? I want you to be a driver. So I want you to ask the hard questions. And then thirdly, like, what are you willing to do or sacrifice to ensure that the things you want for 2020 happen? You know, we're old enough. We've done enough. We've eaten enough hamburgers. We've had enough fun. Now it's time to really decide what we're really, really willing to do in order to get those results. You might have to pass up on some hamburgers, you know. You might have to go out and take a risk, but all courses of action are risky. Prudence is not in doing nothing, but it's in doing bold things and doing them intelligently, you know. So these are the conversations we should be having. We want to take some momentum into this new year. This is what the game's all about. So how do you want this next year to look? What are you willing to do to ensure it looks that way? And what did we learn from 2019? You know, I think those are some good questions to ask, things we need to be thinking about. And if you want to work with me in 2020, get in that training day product, because that's how you get on my training day certified executive protection agents shortlist, which is just people who've gone through the course and that I trust. And beyond that, we'll have access to each other in my paid Facebook group, where I'll be able to help try and coach you and make sure, you know, you get what you want out of your career. But I really just wanted to come to you guys with this episode and just say thank you. Thank you for doing all you've done to make the executive protection lifestyle brand what it is. Thank you for spreading the word and getting the word out so we can all, I can't influence this industry without you out there talking about what we're doing here and recommending episodes to people and all those beautiful things that you guys do, and sharing my podcast episodes in your groups, sharing my podcast episodes all over social media, and resharing them all over Instagram. Like, it's amazing. I can't do these things without you guys. So thank you so much for all those things. And I'll do my best to continue serving you and make sure 2020, I do everything I can to help influence your 2020 positively as we go into the future and take over the world, take over the entire executive protection game. So with no further ado, I just wanted to come to y'all, say thank you, let you know I appreciate y'all, every single one of you. Thanks for all your likes and comments and all the love. You guys give us every time we post something, and get you excited about changes that are coming and things that you are starting to see. Want to encourage you to go check out the Executive Protection Training Day product at executiveprotectiontrainingday.com, because I know that information's next level and it will change your career. If you missed the Protector Symposium, or you just didn't go to protectorsymposium.com and download the replay and watch the replay in our membership portal there. Anyways, y'all, it's been an amazing year. Thanks to you all, your participation, your trust, and your belief in this brand. And I look forward to seeing y'all out there on the next, you know, the stuff that we got coming, you know. So think about the way you want your year to look and purpose in your heart to make sure it looks that way when it's all said and done. This is Byron Rodgers, protector by nature and by trade. I'll see y'all on the next video, podcast, or out in the field. Out. Yo, if you're a private security professional wanting to take your game to the next level, go to executiveprotectiontrainingday.com to check out my personal success package for private security professionals. Essentially, it's everything I know about executive protection and a lot of soft skill training on the techniques, tactics, principles that I believe make it so some protection agents succeed while others fail, regardless of background. Anyways, check it out, executiveprotectiontrainingday.com. And remember, y'all, hard skills do save lives, but soft skills get you paid. Boom. Boom. And to support this podcast, go to executiveprotectionlifestyle.com and contribute to our Patreon account. That Patreon account is what helps me make this podcast possible, contributing to this brand, what we're doing here, making it so that I can bring better guests on, making it so that we can plan more events and just expand the contribution to the private security industry, and also to make America a safer place by teaching people how to protect themselves and the mindset behind that, the lifestyle behind that. You guys are already killing it. $1 a month, $5 a month, $10 a month, $20 a month, whatever you can do that you know you would probably just lose in the mattress anyway or spend on McDonald's. Hey, you want to put it towards something that's going to good use? Put it towards a podcast and get involved in our Patreon account at executiveprotectionlifestyle.com. And if you want to find me, that's ByronRogersMotivation.com. You know, do whatever you can, contribute whatever you can to that Patreon account because it makes all of these things possible, ladies and gentlemen. So much love. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and thank you for making those contributions. You guys rock. We're already doing amazing there, and it's just because of you guys. So thanks once again for those contributions. Boom, I hope you guys enjoyed that episode of Executive Protection Lifestyle Podcast. This whole entire thing actually just started off as a Facebook group that blew up and is one of the fastest growing, if not the fastest growing, executive protection Facebook group online. So if you haven't joined the Facebook group, join the Facebook group. Follow us on Instagram and check us out at executiveprotectionlifestyle.com. If you want to find me, that's ByronRogersMotivation.com. And I'm on all the social media platforms, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook as well. So until the next podcast, y'all, stay sharp out there. And as I say it, one mind, many weapons. Talk soon. Out.